Hello there, this is Tony Schwartz speaking. As a child, I remember hearing the expression, children should be seen and not heard. And in a way, I felt the people that said this really never listened to children. I personally like listening to people, and I find listening to children a wonderful experience, and I like to record children. I'd like to make a few suggestions as to how you might go about this. One thing I think is very important, and that is not to record on several tracks on a tape. If you were to record on several of the tracks in different directions, you would get mixed up and you would inadvertently cut into one track while you were editing the other. So record only in one direction, and I'd like to show you what editing can do. Here, first, is a complete tape.
Then you put it in the oven. Then you cook it for a few minutes, then you take it out, hold it with the pot handles, then cool it off, and if you want to eat it and it's all cooled off, eat it.
What kind of cake is that?
That's vanilla cake.
Oh.
But I'm making a chocolate cake of that one.
I see. Did you make a broccoli cake one time? What did you say about broccoli before?
It has broccoli icing on it, in the icing. So flat over, then top, cool off, bake it, then eat it.
And now the edited version.
I'm making a chocolate cake of that one. You put it in the oven, then you cook it for a few minutes, then you take it out, hold it with the pot handles, then cool it off, and if you want to eat it and it's all cooled off, eat it. It has broccoli icing on it.
I think the edited version is shorter and clearer and gets the idea across quicker. The tape recorder sold today can record at various speeds, and I'd say if you're going to buy a new one, buy one that records at the fastest possible speed. For instance, if they come with 7.5 inches per second, get that one. Recently, I purchased a $180 recorder, and I thought that you might like to see how this recorder sounds at the various speeds it will record at. Here is how my voice sounds on a self-powered, completely portable recorder costing about $180, and I'm recording with a microphone supplied with a recorder at a speed of 1 7/8 inches per second. Here is how my voice sounds on a self-powered, completely portable recorder costing about $180, recording on the microphone supplied with a recorder at a speed of 3 3/4 inches per second. Here is how my voice sounds on a self-powered, completely portable recorder costing about $180. I'm recording on the microphone supplied with a recorder and at a speed of 7.5 inches per second. The microphone supplied with this $180 recorder, strangely, will not give you all the quality that this recorder is capable of. So let's try a microphone that costs $114 on this same recorder and see if we can hear the difference. This is now the sound of my voice as recorded on a $114 microphone going into a $180 recorder. Of course, the quality of the record listening equipment you listen to this record on will also affect the quality of this sound. The better the equipment, the more apparent will be the differences between the recordings made at the different speeds and with the different microphones. So you can see that the faster the speed, the better quality, and the better microphone, the better quality. Also, an advantage of the faster speed is that it's very helpful in editing because you have more tape on which the words take place, and you can cut between them with greater ease. Microphones come in various types, and they are in a way similar to wide-angle and telephoto lenses. There are the cardioid microphones and the omnidirectional microphones. The cardioid is a directional microphone that picks up sound mainly from the front and rejects sound from the rear, and the omnidirectional records sound fairly equally from all around. The microphone I am recording on now is actually a cardioid microphone, and if I were to turn it around as I talk, I'm doing this very slowly, talking at the same level and turning the microphone around, and I'm now talking into the rear of this microphone. Well, when I do that, you see it's fairly hard to hear. And this actually means that when I talk into the front of the microphone, it is rejecting sounds in the rear. And this is very good where there are other people talking in a room, or where there's traffic going by on a street, or where there might be an air conditioner in the room or something like that, or some sound that you don't want to record. You then can talk into the front of the microphone and put the annoying sound to the back of the microphone and have a clear recording. Years ago, people used to think that the studio was a perfect place to record in. In a way, I think that studios were designed for silence, and one can find much more interest in recording in various places. Actually, the sound of the sound can be of additional interest in the recording. And so I'd like to now take a quality recorder, portable recorder, battery-powered recorder, and just walk through my home. I am now recording in my living room, and this is a room with carpeting and soft furniture. We don't have too many drapes. I am now going to walk into our kitchen. There is less soft material around, less than in the living room. There is no carpeting here. There's only a linoleum floor and the plaster walls and ceiling. And I'm now going to walk into a little vestibule going out into the public hall. Now, this is a little 4x4 vestibule, and I'm opening the door and going out into our public hall. Now, here I'm in a hall that has tile floors and marble steps going upstairs, and cement wall and a big glass door, and I think it sounds much more reverberant in that there is less material absorbing the sound. Now I'm going to walk out to the street, and it's a windy day. I'm going to put a windscreen on the recorder to prevent the wind from affecting it. Okay, I'm out in the street now, and the windscreen seems to be needed because the wind is quite strong. If I hold the microphone close to me, you won't notice all the noise, but if I were to hold it the same distance away I had it in the house, you can hear all the surrounding sound, the traffic on the street. There's a brick building across the street, and the cement of the sidewalk in the street. Well, that's the way materials and architecture or surrounding areas can affect sound. I'm going back into the house and back down again to my studio. The other day, my wife and I were driving our 3.5-year-old daughter to school, and I recorded her in the car.
Mommy, now you follow the words with me, but you don't really sing. You only hum of the words. Hum of the words. And she was too riding in a bus. Oh, what fun it was to go, ho, ho, ho. And the summer we were seeing green trees. Not beautiful.
The rumble in the car could actually be quite disturbing. And if you wanted to clear up a recording like that, you could re-record it through your amplifier into another recorder. And by adjusting your tone control, you could take out some of the bass end and thereby come out with a clearer recording like this.
Mommy, now you follow the words with me, but you don't really sing. You only hum of the words. Hum of the words. And she was too riding in a bus. Oh, what fun it was to go, ho, ho, ho. And the summer we were seeing green trees. Not beautiful.
On the rest of this side, I'd like to show you how you can take your tapes and put together stories from the experiences you record.